Welcome. In this video, we will discuss about the increase in tiger numbers in Andhra Pradesh. So yesterday it was the Global Tiger Day, where the the specific good news came for India is that the increase in the number of tigers in Andhra Pradesh. So if you have been following news, you would have known that India has been able to increase its population of tiger by a huge number. In fact, 75% of the population of the tigers in the world is resided in India. So this is particularly a good news, and let's begin. Let's try to see what is specifically, how much is the increase in tiger numbers in Andhra Pradesh, where it was noticed, and then we will also discuss about the All India Tiger Estimate of 2018. So let's begin. First thing that we have to know is what particularly this news is all about. So it pointed out that there has been increase in the number of tigers in Andhra Pradesh during the last 5 years. So since 5 years, the what was earlier measured and checked for, surveyed for, now the number has increased in Andhra Pradesh. Where it has been increased? It has increased in the Nagarjuna Sagar Sri Sai Salem Tiger Reserve. So NSTR is where the rise has been noticed. Now if you see, this particular number has been provided by two important authorities in India. One is WII, your Wildlife Institute of India, and your next one is your Tiger Conservation Authority, National Tiger Conservation Authority. Now let's just try to see a little bit about that. NTCA, your National Tiger Conservative Authority, first of all, it is a statutory body. What does it mean? It has been formed under an act. Which act? Your Wildlife Protection Act. In which year it was passed? 1972. So in 1972, Wildlife Protection Act was passed, which basically formed your National Tiger Conservation Authority. Now this particular authority is major agency for implementing your Project Tiger, which is the one project which actually helped India to increase its population. So basically that's the thing that you have to know about NTCA. Another thing that you have to know is who is the chairman of NTCA. So chairman of NTCA is your minister of, union minister of your environment. So it's like your union minister of Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change is the one who heads the NTCA. So these are the few things that you have to know about NTCA. Now coming to the WII, Wildlife Institute of India, it is situated in Dehradun and it is an autonomous body working under the Ministry of Environment. So these are the few things that you have to know about WII and NTCA. Now let's go back and see what the report was about. So as mentioned earlier, there has been reported increase in the number of tigers. Now another thing that you have to know, it's about the Nagarjuna Sri Sai Salem National Tiger Reserve, its location. So it is located in the Telangana Andhra Pradesh region and it is the largest tiger reserve in India. So if there is any question where they were asking which is the largest tiger reserve in India, your answer would be your Nagarjuna Sri Sai Salem Tiger Reserve. Also, an important thing to remember over here is Krishna River actually cuts through it. So you have to remember the river which actually cuts through this particular reserve is your Krishna River. Now let's, like in the map, let's just see the location. So if you see, it is actually located over here almost on the border of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So it's like not clearly demarked, it's on the border of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So your Nagarjuna Sri Sai Salem Tiger Reserve is located over there. So now once we have discussed about where the tiger increase has been noticed in the latest report by NTCA and WII, let's also look into a very important report which was published last year. It was All India Tiger Estimates of 2018. It is a very important report and it actually shows that how Indian efforts towards conserving the population of tiger has borne fruit. So if you see the tiger census, it is also known as tiger census, it says that the count has risen to 2967 from 2226 in 2014. So in 4 years, what you have seen is 33% increase in the population, which is a huge population boost. So which means that the efforts which has been put in place by the government or by different NGOs, they have actually worked, and the tigers were able to increase their population by 33%. Now, one thing, like just a fact that you should know, that tiger is a keystone species. Now, keystone species in a ecology or in an ecosystem is the one which actually help to revive the whole ecosystem. So if a keystone species is gone, the ecosystem actually suffer catastrophic result from it. And by conserving a keystone species, we can actually multiply the conservation effort. So that is why conservation of tiger was very important. And India was able to do a lot. If you in fact see, India was able to achieve the target of doubling the tiger count even 4 years earlier than what it actually pledged for. So it pledged for doubling of tiger counts by 2022, but it was able to do it by 2018 itself, which is a remarkable achievement. Now in the country itself, Madhya Pradesh is the state which has the largest number of tigers. So the largest number of tiger in India are found in Madhya Pradesh. You have many important tiger reserves over there. Go back and check in your atlas. See where all the major tiger reserves in Madhya Pradesh are located. Where is Panch, where is Kanha, where is Panna. Just look at all these and just know that Madhya Pradesh is the state with the highest number of tiger reserves and tiger population. Now, let's also just see the different aspects where the tiger are present. So if you see, the red line over here talks about the central India, which is where the Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra are located. So if you see, from 2014 to 2018, it has seen the sharpest increase. So the central India is the one which has seen the sharpest rise in the population of tiger. Now if you see green is the western ghats. Your Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, these region have also seen an increase. So if you see, but they have been seeing increase in fact from 2010 onwards. So from 2010 onward, you can see there has been an increase in the population of tiger in western ghat region. Now your yellow line is about the Shivalik range, so the foothill of Himalayas. Here if you see, there also has been increase. Starting from 2010 itself, there has been increase in the population of your tiger in the Shivalik range. Now finally, your gray line is talking about the northeastern hills. So the eastern Himalayas, there also has been increase in the number of tiger. But if you see, the rise is not as sharp as seen in other places in India. So in the eastern Himalayas, the rise is there, but still it is not very sharp. In fact, Mizoram is considered as the one of the state where the rise has been the slowest in terms of population of tiger. And finally, we are seeing the Sundarban. The blue line here signifies the Sundarban areas, which is the Brahmaputra Ganga deltic region. And here if you see, increase is there, but increase is not so sharp. So which is the major area where the population of tiger in India has increased? These include your central India, your western ghat, as well as your Shivalik area. So the foothills of Himalayas, the northern India, your western ghats, the part of your southern western India, as well as your central India. These are the major areas where the population has increased. And if you see, overall the population has increased from 1411 in 2006 to 2967. 2967 is the present estimate, which is like a huge jump. It's doubling of, it has already been done, and that is what India has committed by 2022, but by 2018 only they are able to get this. So I hope you have liked this video, you have understood. So the things you have to remember from this video is basically the working of NTCA, WII, the increase in the population in Andhra Pradesh, where it is increased, what is the location of your NTAS and NSTR Tiger Reserve, Nagarjuna Sagar Sisai Salem Tiger Reserve. And then you have to also know the important facts of your All India Estimate of 2018. So I hope you have liked this video. If you have any doubt, please comment. Thank you.